Well, good morning, everyone. I hope that your week is off to a great start, and we're going to be in Psalm 46 this morning. And I want you to think of Psalm 46 as not some place that we run to when we get into trouble. It's the place we live, and when trouble comes, we're already there. I think a lot of times people get that mixed up, and they think that God is just a refuge when we have a storm. No, he's our dwelling place that can handle anything that life dishes out. And so I want you to just kind of listen to this, and I think you'll better understand how I get to this place of thinking that it's not something we run to for a time or two in our lives when there's trouble. It's something we live in so that when trouble comes, we're already prepared. And so let me read this to you, and let's see if you don't see the same thing. It says in verse number 1 of Psalm 46, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. See that? A very present help in trouble. He's not something we run to, it's something we dwell in. And therefore, will not we fear, though the earth be removed and though the mountains be carried in the midst of the sea, the waters thereof roar and be troubled, though the mountains shake with the swelling thereof, there is a river and the streams whereof shall make glad the city of God, a holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. Listen, God is in the midst of her, she shall not be moved. And so we're supposed to be in that dwelling place all the time. God's in the midst of her, and we shall not be moved. God shall help her and her right early. That means he's never late. He's always on time. In fact, he is ready to lead us through trouble before we even know trouble is coming. That's why it's important to dwell in him all the time, not run to him only when we need him. Verse number 6 says, the heathen raged, the kingdoms were moved. He uttered his voice, the earth melted. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Look what he says right here in verse number 8. He says, come behold the works of the Lord, what desolation he hath made in the earth. He maketh wars to cease unto the end of the earth. He breaketh the bow and cutteth the spear asunder. He burneth the chariot in the fire. Listen, be still and know that I am God. I will be exalted among the heathen. I will be exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. And so it's not something we run to when we feel like we suddenly need him. It's something that we live within the confines of at all times. That way, we only encounter the trouble that is unavoidable, and he has already seen it and prepared our path through it because we're in him all the time. God is always our refuge. God is always our strength. God is always our help. He's always early. He's always these things if we dwell in him. And so as you start your brand new day, as you head into a brand new week, let God be your refuge, not the one you run to. It's not a keep we run to help us only when there's an enemy attacking. It's the place we dwell at all times. That way, God is already the centerpiece. And we're not running to him in the midst of a tragedy. We're with him when tragedy strikes. If you'll really apply this to your life and really make this true, that you are in God at all times, that you are living for him, he's the center of your life, he will always give you the best day possible. I hope that helps.